Okay, good. Thank you. So as you guys seen yesterday, we have covered the topics like, you know, the basic understanding of the talent ETL tool, like what is the purpose, how it is built and how it was built, everything we discussed yesterday. And also we have gone through the sample job to understand the fixed flow input. So basically fixed flow input, whatever the input you wanted to pass, that statically we can pass from this component. And also we have seen the scenario like how it can be displayed on the console. So that is covered in yesterday. So today we will try to cover up some of the things using file components, and also I will try to cover a few topics related to the joins. Okay. Can you create a new sample job? Maybe you can name it as sample job file, sample job or something like that, or sample job 2, anything you can have. Sample job 2 you can name, and purpose or description you can write, like, you know, file usage, file component usage, or, you know, file usage, something you can write. And yes, you can click on finish. Yes, this one is open now. So now let us try to create some sample files for processing purpose. Can you create some sample files in your local machine? Sachin, minimize this. Go to your desktop and do create some sample files, like, you know, one file with employee details, like employee name, employee address, and employee department. And create another file, in that put department name, department ID. So we can have two different files. Are you able to minimize this?
Yes, sir. Yes.
But I still see your talent studio only. I think you are sharing. Please share your desktop so that we'll be able to see all the screens. Yes. Okay. Good. 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 Yeah. Now I can see it. So employee ID, employee number, and you can put department name. Okay. And I think 3 columns should be sufficient. And this one, the file name, you can save it as employee file. Just put EMP or something like that. EMP, and you can create it as a text file, .txt file. That should be fine. Okay, save it, and just give some values here. Give enter, and 1 comma, employee ID is 1, employee number put 101, something like that. Department, you can put IT. Or HR, anything. Yeah, just have some sample records, maybe 4 or 5 records you can insert. Anything, you can give computer science, MBA, anything. Department, HR department, finance department. Good, I think fair enough. So totally 5 records we have in employee table along with their department numbers. Okay, just save this one and create one more file with department ID, department name. And do insert some values there. For department name, you can give same values which we have used here in employee table. And then for department ID, you can have some IDs, any numerical IDs. I can see only your employee file. Now I can see the department. Okay, IT, HR, and you can have all like MBA, whatever you have put there. Okay, save this one, and you can have name it as, you can name it as department, DEP, something like that. Okay, all right. Now open your Talent Studio. Do share your talent screen. I can see your desktop now. I can also see your talent mission now. Yeah, I can see it. No issues. Now you have two files basically. Okay, first of all, we will see how to read the file from your local mission to talent environment. Okay. And so in order to read the file, any file, it can be your TXT file, it can be Excel file, it can be, you know, .dat file, any file, irrespective of what extension it has and what delimiter it has, irrespective of it, we can read the file using T input file delimiter component. Can you go for that component once? T file input delimiter component. Yes, that is the one. So using this component, we do read all the data which is in the form of files. Now double click on this component. Okay, can you maximize the component view? So basically it is asking few details here. Row separator, yes, new line, which is slash n, that is correct. And the field separator, not semicolon, I think we have used comma. So that we need to change here. So whatever the delimiter we have, that delimiter we need to change accordingly. So comma should be in double quotes. So you understood, right? Why we are giving comma here? Because the field separator in your file is comma. Employee name, employee number, those two columns are getting separated by comma. So that's the reason we are giving it as comma here. And then it is asking CSV options. It is not a CSV file. I think you are having TXT file, right? So this option is not required. And now you have something called schema here. So click on the schema. Let us give the schema as per input file, employee file. You can give employee file columns here, like employee name, all those things you have given, right? I think totally three columns you have in employee table. Employee ID, employee name, department name. It is, employee ID. Employee name, and the third one, department name. Okay, good. So now you have the schema, you have the source file, and now you are good enough to read that one. So you just need to select that path accordingly here. Now in the file name, you are seeing some other file. So yes, click on that, Dougal, and go to your file and choose that file here. The path will be automatically populated here. Yeah, I think EMP table, you need to, EMP file, you need to choose. Yes, it is there. Yeah. Now you have given the path and also the file name has come here. Good. Now minimize the component view. Yes, you can use a T log row component now. Type on design view, T log row. On design view, click on design view. Yes, T log row. Good. Yeah. Yes, now the first component link it to the second component using the main link. So as I explained yesterday, in links we have different links. The main actually carries the schema from current component to very next component. Okay, now go to T-log row and sync your schema. Okay, everything will be synced, and the table format you can choose so that the data will be displayed in the form of table. Now please proceed to run your job. So now you have read the file and also the data which is there in the file. You can actually see here, right? You can double check whether all the data has come as it is or any changes are there. So it's basically whatever the data you have inserted here, everything has come here. Now, if you wanted to make any changes in the file, you can make any changes. Maybe you can remove one record. Save it. And then execute your job. So that should be reflected here. So it is reflected. So far, any doubts, guys? Are you all clear till this point?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. Yes, fair sir. Enough. Fair enough. So now we have seen how to read the data from file. Now let us also do some changes in the same file. Can you open that employee file? We will make some small changes here. Now we have removed one line and we have seen that the data is getting reflected automatically, whatever is there in the file. That is correct. And now let us change the delimiter. Now we have the delimiter as comma, right? Let us change it to some pipe symbol. So when you have pipe symbol here and give a comma in the job, right, that would not work. So whatever the symbol or delimiter you give here, the same thing we need to choose there. Then only it will read the data accordingly. Otherwise it will not read the data. So whenever you choose this component to read the input files, you need to make sure that how many columns are there, those columns should be defined in the schema accordingly. So in this file, we have totally three columns. All those three columns are defined in the schema. That is very first thing. And the second thing is delimiter. You need to see whether the delimiter is comma or, you know, pipe symbol or some other thing. Header also should have same. Sachin, can you also change in the header? Yes. That also we need to change it from comma to pipe. Delimiter, yeah. Yes. Now save the file. Now go and run your job without making any changes. You see what happens here. See what happened here. You have given the schema 3, okay, but the delimiter you have given comma. So since there is no comma in the file, what happened is that whatever is there in the file, it is treated as a one single column. So that is how the mismatches will come. So it is happening because the delimiter which you have given in the job is comma, not pipe symbol. Now go to file component and in component view, change the delimiter. You will see the exact match after running the job, after you change it to pipe symbol. Now go remove the comma and just put pipe symbol. Run your job. Now you see what happened here. So it is coming as expected. So that is how it acts. So when you are not giving the proper delimiter, the data will come in different way. So if you want the data in the same way like how it is in file, then we need to use the right delimiter. Okay, that is one thing. Now let us do few more changes to the file itself. Now let us change the file extension. Go to your Windows Explorer. Save this file as .dat. Save as. Instead of txt, just choose .dat. Just put .dat there itself. Yeah, just .dat. Now select this one, save this one. Okay, so now can you go to your job and go to the component? No, do not run it. Just go to your input file component. So here, if you see the file name, we have given it as .txt. So you have the .txt and also you have the .dat file in your folder. So let us assume we need to run both the files. We need to run both the files. So in that case, what we have to do is, if we remove the .txt and put star, it will read all the files with that same name. And one more thing we need to test. So when you do not have that file in the respective directory, it will throw error.
For example, now change that employee.txt to employee.csv. So generally the CSV file is not there. So when the file is not there, it is expected to fail the job. Now can you run the job? Now see what happened. It has thrown error saying that system cannot find the file. Now can you minimize this and go to component view of file delimiter component? Yeah, go to component view. Yes, maximize this. So basically here we have one feature in Talend which actually says die on error. Now if you actually see, it has shown you the error message, but the job did not fail. The job has completed successfully, but there is an error. So even though there is an error, the job has completed successfully without giving any error. Why? Because there is an option called die on error here. We did not check that. Now you see at the bottom we have something called die on error. Can you enable it? Yes. So this one you will find it in almost all the components in Talend. If in case it is not checked right, that will not fail the job. The job will complete it successfully, but the error message will be there in the lock. Now let us assume when there is an error, we just wanted it to be failed. So in that case, we need to enable this die on error so that the job will be failed with the error message. Now can you run the job? See, the job is failed and you can see the error message. Now you can actually ask me, how we know, sir, whether the job has completed successfully or not? Because in previous execution also we have seen that job ran and now also the job ran, but how will we know whether it has failed or not? Previous run also has some error message. Now this run also has some error message, but how do we know, sir? You can ask me this question. So let me answer that question. So if you see here at the end, you have something called exit code. So exit code, what is the exit code here? It is 1. So when the exit code equal to 1, that means the job is failed. When the exit code equal to 0, the job is successful. I am not sure whether you have noticed the exit code in the previous execution or not. Let us fix the issue and run the job again. Can you minimize the run window? Yes. Now go to your file component. Double click on the component. Yep. So now just give the correct file name here. You have .txt, .dat, whatever you want, you can give here. Yes, now go ahead and run your job. That means you are fixing the issue in the job. The issue is fixed now. See the exit code? 0. So this point is very important in Talend. So when the exit code equal to 0, it is successful. When the exit code equal to 1, that means it is failed. Very good. So till this point, are we all clear?
Yes, sir.
Good. Now let us try to place the data in file. Okay, now we are printing on the console, but let's see, you have a .dat file input, right? But you want that file to be created as a CSV file. So in that case, how can we do it in Talend? So that I will show you now. Okay, now go to design view and choose T file output delimited component. Another new component in Talend here. Right, exactly. Choose that. So it is very similar component, file component, but what it does is it actually generates the file, new file, in whichever the format you want, it will generate in that format. Now add those two components with the main link again, Sachin. Put the link from tlog row to that third component. You need to right click there on the on the second component. Yes, main, choose main. Yeah, place it on that. Yes, yeah, you can just select on that component after you choose. Otherwise you can also do one thing. You can remove the tlog row and have the link directly from your input first component to file output component. You can now take the main link and place it on your output component directly.
Sir?
You need to choose output delimited component.
Yes.
I think you have chosen input delimited, right? So that is the reason it is not allowing you. Let me show you another way how to choose the component, okay? Can you click on the first component, right click on the first component? So there is another way as well. Now choose row, main, do not put on that component, just start typing something, t file output something you type, start typing. No. Actually, that when you click on that main and then click on the designer view, right? Yeah, just type that, choose that one, first one, very first one. That's fine. I can show you that later. Now you can add those two components, first one and the second component with main. So basically, the same component cannot be connected. So technically, input cannot be connected to input. Why? Because input always receives the input. Okay, and then it passes to the next component. Output, it always receives from the input component and then it will generate something new. Okay, now you have input side input and output side output. Now double click on the output. Now basically what you see here, you see some other path, right? So let us assume the from source side you have dot dat file. Now which format you want? Let's say you want CSV, okay? Now select the path, just select your desktop or downloads or any other folder, specific folder. Like the place where you have input file, right? Go to that folder and do not choose anything, just select this path alone. Yes, open. So now the file name, whatever the file name you want, you can give it here. After desktop, you have out.csv, right? You can change that. You can change that to samplejob2.csv. Or you can put like samplejob2_out.csv. Okay. So generally, guys, whatever the name you want, right? That name you can give here. It can be anything. You can give rahul.csv. You can give swati.csv. You can give lakshaykumar.csv. Sugosh.csv, Sachin.csv, anything, whatever the name you wanted to define, we can give it there. Now delimiter, what delimiter you want in CSV? So basically CSV files will have comma delimiter. So let's have the comma as a file delimiter. Good. Now click on the sync schema so that the same schema will be populated here. Now proceed to run your job and see what happens here. So you are not seeing anything on the console. You can ask me why. Can anyone tell me why the data is not on console now?
Sir, the file in the input was not selected.
No.
Sir, the file, whatever the data we have selected is in our out file.
Exactly. So we have replaced the tlogro component with t output file delimiter component. So remember guys, whenever you use tlogro component, that only logs the information on the log. So if you go to your job design view, there is no tlogro component. We have removed it. So if you put tlogro at the end, that will display the data. Now add tlogro at the end. Have main from second component to third component. And then run your job after syncing the schema and choosing the table view. What happened? Click on the second component. What is the error? It actually says the file already exists. Can you go to log once? Run view. Run view. Yeah, click on run. So what is the error message? So generally, guys, it says file already exists with the same name. So in that case, what you have to do is click on your second component, that output component. So there are some options here in the output component. Okay, so if you click on the advanced settings, go to advanced settings. So there you can actually see throw an error if the file already exists. So what it does is it will throw an error if the file already exists. Just uncheck that. So if you uncheck that, it will not throw any error when the file already exists. And there is another option you can see, create directory if not exist. That means when the file is not exist, then the file will be created automatically. Okay. Now go to basic setting. Basic setting. You can notice something here. We have something called append. So what happens is that, let us assume we have same file. Okay. And you are trying to generate the file again with the same name. So what's happening? It says that the file already exists. So when the file exists, you do not want to get the error. Let's assume you wanted to just append the data to the already existing file. Meaning to say you already have 10 records in the file. And you want to add all the new records which are coming from the input to the same file again. So that time what we can do is we can choose the append. Click on the append. I will show you how the file will be default. Now run your job. Can you minimize it? So you are using tlogro. That's the reason the data is on your log. That is clear to everyone, right? Now the file is generated in the path. Can you go to that path and open the file, target file? So we have generated the file in the form of CSV. So it is not TXT or it is not DAT. It is CSV file now. So when there is a requirement to change the file format or file data or something like that, what we have to do is we have to design a job something like this, and then we just need to schedule that job. So whenever the file comes in the source path, that will pick the data and that will generate in the form of .csv. So these kind of file requirements we can handle using this simple job. Now you can ask me why there are two sets of records, sir. Why there are two sets of records? Can someone tell me? I have explained it just before. There are two sets of records because you have selected append option. So when you choose append, it will keep appending the records. Now if you run one more time, right, another set of records will be inserted. But my suggestion is whenever you choose append, because file already in use. So when the file is in open mode, you cannot use that file. So you need to close the file from your system. Because when it is in use, it will not be taken from the tenant. Now see, it ran it successfully. So now I just wanted to tell you something. When you choose append, just uncheck the header, because now you see the header is repeating again and again. That is void. So now go to your job. Double click on that component view. Second component view. Yes. Now whenever you guys choose append, make sure to uncheck include header. So include header is also there from the input side. If you see in the input component, there also you have include header. So here also you have include header. So include header means for this component, whatever you define in the schema, that is your header. And for the input component also, for that current component, whatever the schema is there, that will be treated as a header. So now you go to the input delimiter component and uncheck your schema there and here, both the places. Include header. Do you see anything, something called include header? Advanced settings. Okay, sorry, I think you have opened input, right? Sorry, you can go to the output component. Output component itself, yes. Now maximize this. Okay, I think you have append and also include header. So run the job and see how the data will get referred there. So on the log itself, you can see something. So what happened? File is in open mode, is it? Yeah, need to be closed. See what happened? There are two headers included now. One is an actual header and the other one you could see on the log is other header. So now exclude that and run the job again. file is on open mode. Sorry, I just wanted to run that multiple times so that you people can understand all scenarios for each and every small feature. Okay, so in this way we can output the file in the form of file, and now minimize it and change the extension. Sachin, just change the file extension. Maybe you can give a .txt. Double click on the component. No. This one is not needed. Second component. Yeah, double click there. Yes, this one we have seen. We have read different input files, right? Now we have generated CSV file. Let us generate txt file. Just remove that CSV and put txt so that the txt file will be generated. Now run your job. Go to your path and see whether the txt file is generated there or not. It is generated, right? So that is how it is. So using this file input, you can read any file, and you know, you can output any file. So that is about file components. Okay, now I wanted to ask you, if you have any questions, you can ask me. Do you guys have any questions so far? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. So are you all following me till this point?
Yes, sir.
Okay, very good, guys. Very good. I really appreciate that. You know, you guys are trying to understand whatever I explain. Good, that is good. And now I would like to ask you, like, what assignment I have given you yesterday to install the studio and to do the job till the point we have done. And the other thing is SQL joins. So did you guys brush up your joins skills? I hope you would have learned about what is join and all. Can someone tell me what is join and what are the different type of joins?
Oh. Yes, sir.
Hello.
Anyone can explain.
Okay, sir. Sir, joins are clause in an SQL where you can use them to combine different tables. Different rows and different tables in a database, rather than making another database with data set of two tables. You can use them to combine a data table.
Okay, good. And what are the different joins which we have?
So inner join and outer join and group join.
There is no group join. We have inner join.
We have two joins, inner joins and outer join. Mm-hmm. So basically in inner we have only inner join, in outer we have left outer join, right outer join and full outer join.
Very good. Absolutely. Very good. So in tomorrow's session we will see how can we perform the joins from Talent. Okay. Now we actually created two files, right? One is employee file and the other one is a department file. So tomorrow session I will show you how to perform the joins from files and as well as from different databases. Okay. And the assignment for tomorrow is that everyone should complete the sample job one, sample job two till this point. Okay. If you have any doubts, refer to Sachin Mission and take the reference from it. Okay. And the assignment, when it comes to assignments, joins, if someone is not clear about it, please brush up your skills on SQL joins. If you have any doubts, definitely I will explain you the joins as well in our upcoming sessions, probably on tomorrow. Okay, that is one thing. And other than this SQL joins, I was thinking to ask you something. Yes. We need some database, okay? Like how you have downloaded the Talend open source tool, right? In a similar fashion, there are so many open source, like you know, MySQL we have. So I suggest you guys to download any of the open source database and get it installed for tomorrow's session, okay? So that in our future section, we can also cover up all the database scenarios from Talend. Now we have seen sample files and we can see something from database tables as well. So which database you can download MySQL
you all can just go to Google and download MySQL. If you type, it will come in a way how you have downloaded Talent DTL tool, right? Same way, download that software and get it installed for tomorrow's session, guys. Okay, that is all I have for today. If you
so
guys,
I already I already have PLSQL, PSQL, PostgreSQL.
Okay, I want all of you to have a same database. It can be anything, whichever you feel comfortable, you can have that SQL Server, MySQL, anything. So discuss among you guys. It is okay to have additional databases as well, but when we go through the sample jobs and creation of sample jobs, right, it's better to have same tables like how we have created files. Now in the same fashion, we will create some tables and then I will explain you all the scenarios. So have some common database installed in all your missions for tomorrow session. Discuss and whichever you feel, SQL Server or MySQL and any other open source you wanted to download and install, you can have that installed. Okay. All right, guys, I think I'm good for today. If we do not have any calls, we can wrap up.